5 minutes past seven right now in KSFO. Brian Sussman with you, and we welcome not only those of you listening via the broadcast airwaves of KSFO, but those listening online from all over the world. And you tune in because, well, one, many of you do listen to us regularly, but two, a lot of you follow this guest, and he's Gerald Celente. He's like a rock star in certain corners of the internet world, and he has a great, great magazine called The Trends Journal. We'll tell you how you can get a copy of that in short order. Mr. Celente, please, how are you, sir?
Oh, fine. Thank you so much for having me on, Brian.
Well, we always enjoy it, and you're a guy who tells it like it is. You call it as you see it. You describe yourself as a political atheist, so you've got no skin in the game politically. But I just got to ask you, this credit rating, Gerald Celente, we were playing, in fact, Sherry, since we've got a little extended time with Gerald, can we play that clip of Timothy Geithner, Treasury Secretary from April, when he's on Fox Business News? And Mr. Geithner, I know you've heard this, but I want our listeners who are just joining us this morning to listen to Geithner back in April. Here we go.
Is there a risk that the United States could lose its AAA credit rating, yes or no?
No risk of that.
No risk.
No risk. Again, if you listen carefully now, you see the leadership of the United States of America, the president, the Republican leadership in both houses, and the Democrats recognizing now this is the right thing to do for the economy, that we have to put in place now reforms that bring down our long-term deficits in ways that will help strengthen future growth. And that's incredibly important recognition by people. And we'd like to put something in place as soon as we can so we can begin that process.
So Standard & Poor's is wrong. The United States will keep its AAA credit rating.
You know, people, absolutely.
Absolutely, Mr. Celente. Absolutely, he said.
It's one thing after another. This goes way back. It's like dredging out Alan Greenspan all over the media saying what's going to happen next after he's responsible also for helping create this debacle by devaluing the dollar with these record low interest rates following 9/11 and right up until now virtually. And now they're asking him, are we going to go into a recession? And he says, no. Why would anybody believe anything the government says? Read my lips, no new taxes. I didn't have sex with that woman, Monica Lewinsky. I smoked, but I didn't inhale. Saddam Hussein has weapons of mass destruction and ties to Al-Qaeda. Timothy Geithner, one after another. These are psychopaths and sociopaths. I mean, that's all they are. And people, look, Brian, you just saw a month and a half of the D.C. drama queens put on a spectacle that really prompted S&P to also issue this warning because of the behavior and the incompetence that they showed everyone out there, how inept they are and unqualified they are to deal with this problem. We're looking at $48,000 each one of us holding debt. How are they going to pay? We're going to pay that back. It will never be paid back.
Okay, so it's never going to be paid back. What is the plan here? I mean, President Obama gets on the air yesterday finally talking about this devaluing of our, talking about the downgrade, and as he's speaking, he's showing no confidence whatsoever. He's blaming everybody under the sun. He talks about raising taxes, and the entire time, the market just continues to tank.
Exactly, and that's why the whole, and this isn't, by the way, this isn't only what's going on in the U.S. You have the cavalcade of clowns out there over in the EU that are playing the same kind of a game. Yeah, I mean, every time Berlusconi gets out there and says he has a solution to deal with the problem, so we're looking at a global meltdown. We have people in power. It's over their heads. Look at the markets as we're speaking now. They rebounded on the good news that Ben Bernanke may have a plan to solve the problem. Oh, my God. This is called insanity. Repeating the same mistake over and over again and thinking it's going to turn out differently. There's no way out of this.
The problem, clearly, is overspending. And so S&P in their downgrading, and I read, and I'm sure you read it as well. I know you had to read it. You've probably written about it by now. I read the 8-page PDF. 28 times they talked about our debt. This is all about our debt, all about our overspending, isn't it?
Exactly. And by the way, you could compare us to Portugal. So all those people that say it was politically motivated, this and that, no, it's not. Look at the numbers, only the numbers. As I said, how are we individually, we're in debt, $48,000 per person, how are we going to pay that back? It can't be paid back. That's why you're seeing gold prices, what, about $1,740 an ounce. They spiked a couple of hundred dollars in just a month. Because the whole world knows what's going on. You heard Greenspan say it. We're not going to default. We could continue to print money. He should have been put on trial after that one. You continue to print money? You mean you can continue to devaluate our currency and rob from all of us who have been working and saving and trying to scrape by so we can pay off this debt that you clowns accumulated?
Gerald, for those who think you may be making this up, we have the audio of that. It takes about 5 seconds to play. Here is Alan Greenspan admitting that the way we paint over our debt in this country is just to print money. Listen to this.
The United States can pay any debt it has because we can always print money to do that. So there is zero probability of default.
You know, for those of us who always would, you know, criticize, I'm sure you, I know they criticize me. What do you mean we print money? Oh, come on, you right-wingers, you crazy conservatives, oh, you Tea Partiers, you lunatics are just making this stuff up. There's Alan Greenspan saying it.
I know. This is what I'm saying. He should be brought on trial. He should be brought on trial for the destruction of the United States of America. All of them. And there's zero chance that we will default on it. Zero chance. Yeah, zero chance. Because the zeros are adding more zeros to the dollar to make it worthless. It's like the Zimbabwean dollar. And what they're doing is they're robbing our future and they're robbing our present. And the prostitutes. They should change the name of that show, by the way, on Sunday morning. It should be Meet the Prostitutes. And NBC, CBS, ABC, NPR, PBS, they should be the Houses of Prostitution. I'm serious. How would you get away with this? You would never let your buddy get away with this.
No, you wouldn't.
If you were sitting next to any of your friends, anybody across the dinner table, a girlfriend, I don't care who it is, you'd say, come on, save the baloney for somebody else. Don't talk to me like that.
Or if this were the private sector, people would be going to jail right now.
Not anymore, because it's the merger of state and corporate powers. It's called fascism. Look what the private sector did to us. The Goldman Sachs gang, the Merrill Lynch mob, the Lehman Boys, the Citigroup gang. Nobody goes to jail. Only, you know, if you're selling raw milk.
I tried to look up a skirt, but it doesn't listen.
Hey, now, here's the other question, Gerald. Bank of America, speaking of that, is in real serious trouble right now. They're a huge bank. Their stock is tanking. Some say they're insolvent. Are we looking for another bailout towards B of A?
I mean, of course they're going to be. And this is also, Brian, let's look at the facts on this. The two big to fails that, who started this one? What was his name? Henry Paulson, the former CEO of Goldman Sachs,
right.
Treasury Secretary under Bush,
right.
The too big to fail baloney,
right.
They're now 20% bigger than they were before. So yes, they're going to have to bail them out. And by the way, we're also, you know, we've been warning that they're going to impose some level of economic martial law. Now I say that's not inflammatory or conspiracy theorist, it's a fact. So here's the kind of way they do it. A bank holiday. Sound familiar? They've done it before, haven't they? Remember on the FDR? Holiday. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. You can't get your money out. And when you get your money out, like they did the last time, it's going to be worth less than it was when you had it in there. How did they do that? Well, they repegged the price of gold. They forced the American people to turn in all their gold to the government at $21.62 an ounce. After they got it all in, they repegged the price of gold, because in those days the dollar was pegged to gold, to $35 an ounce. That meant you next day you just lost 40% of your purchasing power. They don't teach you that in school, do they? In economics 101. And then what we're looking at now, we believe that they are going to put a ceiling on gold prices, and they're going to blame the people that have been buying gold as the cause for bringing down the American economy and the dollar. Just like Michael Moore is yelling out about, you know, about S&P for what they did. He should stick to making movies because he doesn't know his numbers or his facts. This thing should have been downgraded as they've downgraded the other debt around the world with similar ratios a long time ago.
Gerald Celente with us on KSFO, the Trends Research Institute. He's been forecasting worldwide trends since 1980, and he's got a great journal, the Trends Journal. I'll tell you how you'll be able to get a hold of that in just a moment, and then when we return in just a quick second, I want to make sure that Gerald gives us his latest trends forecasting. You just heard what he said about gold. We'll go into that further in case you missed it, but I want to hear what else he's trending, what he's forecasting. Officer Vic, though, with a quick word from our sponsor, and we also have, of course, a little traffic, too. Officer Vic. Okay, Gerald Celente is my good friend. He has the Trends Journal, which is truly one of the best magazines available. We'll tell you how you can get a copy of that in just a moment. He forecasts trends, and he has no skin in the game politically. He's not a fan of either party, quite frankly. He's just a guy that looks at numbers and looks at the facts and makes trends. So, Mr. Celente, I think we need to backtrack here. You were just saying something about gold. Now, I will tell you, folks, Gerald Celente was talking about this day in which we live right now with the downgrade and everything. He was talking about this a couple years ago. It's happened. You've got our attention. What are your thoughts on gold again, Gerald?
We believe that the central banks and the Federal Reserve are going to try to drive down the price and probably regulate its price, just as they've done before, put a peg on it, because people all around the world are dumping out of their fiat currencies into gold. It has nothing to do with speculators, but they're going to blame the speculators. There may even become a time, they've done it before, they can do it again. Under FDR, they forced confiscation of gold. And look what they're doing to us when we get on an airplane. You think they'll steal our gold, you know? We get on an airplane, you know? You want to talk about being intrusive.
Right.
So, yeah, this is a reality. And also, I want to make this very clear. When I say this, I'm only giving facts, and I'm not a conspiracy theorist. So what I have to say next, I say this in the same spirit. They're manipulating the markets as we're speaking now. And not only gold, but the stock markets, the equity markets worldwide. And how can I say that? Well, let's go back to the one-time reporting that we found out through the Dodd-Frank bill that the Federal Reserve was doing backdoor deals worth over $20 trillion after the collapse in 2008 that we would have never found out about. So don't think for one moment, Brian, they're not doing the same thing now. And it's a sucker's game. And you pick up the front page of the New York Times today, which I affectionately call, they call themselves the paper of record. I look at it as more as the toilet paper of record. The wave of worry threatens to build on itself. And they go on to say, everybody gets into this hangdog demeanor with respect to economic expectations, says Paul Lucidina, chairman of A.T. Kearney, a consulting firm. People sit on their wallets because they feel everything is going to get worse. And things get worse because people are sitting on their wallets. So, in other words, don't worry about what's going on in front of you. You don't have money. Go out and spend it anyway. Mm-hmm. It's going to be much better. So they're chumming people into the game. You see all these barkers, or Wall Street barkers on CNBC, the other shows. You know, this is a buying opportunity. I haven't heard one of them saying it's a selling opportunity. So what we're saying is be very cautious now. Things are going to get a lot worse. And again, you have to look at the bigger picture. You read the Spring Trends Journal, the first great war of the 21st century. And what we kept saying over and over again throughout the last 2 years, you're going to see riots breaking out worldwide. And they're re-engineering history. They're saying what happened over in the Middle East and North Africa, pro-democracy movements. No, they're not. They're angry people who have no money and they have no future, and all the money's at the top of the pyramid. Look what's going on in Israel as we speak. 150,000 people took to the streets in tents. Why? For the same reason. A couple of, and read Haaretz, the Israeli newspapers, all of them, Jerusalem Post, they'll all say the same thing. The people are angry because a few people, the monopolies, the oligarchs, are controlling everything, and the rest of the people can't make ends meet. Look what happened as we're speaking over in the UK, going into its fourth night of riots.
Right.
Oh, it was because a policeman shot a... Yeah, nah. No, that was, that's like saying World War I began because the Archduke Ferdinand was assassinated at Sarajevo. It's a lot of angry people. When the money stops flowing down to the man on the street, the blood starts flowing in the streets, and the blood is flowing around the world, in Greece, in Spain, in Portugal, in UK. It's happening everywhere. The system is collapsing in front of us. But, Mr. Sorrenti, don't be pessimistic. Ben Bernanke has a new plan.
And Obama has a new plan as well. And
yeah,
everything Obama gave us was more government spending. He gave us his plan. It entailed more government spending. That's his plan.
Hey, and what happened, Brian? Remember that brilliant team he put together? With, you know, Christina Romo.
Oh, yeah.
And Goolsbee.
Oh, yeah.
And remember, my favorite of all favorites, the prostitutes could never say his word without putting brilliant either before, in the middle, or after. And you know who it is. The brilliant Larry Summers.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, who engineered this debacle. And what did they say when they gave us the Obama stimulus baloney? That by this time, our unemployment rate would be down to 7.2% rather than the 9.1%. And, of course, you well know that number is cooked. And this is another important thing to understand. As we're going into this decline, this is a lot different than the panic of 08. Because when that happened, we people still believed their real estate had value to it. People still didn't know that the whole system was collapsing around them. Their unemployment was 4.7%, not what it is now. So we're going now, and you're hearing everybody cutting back, cutting back, cutting back, cutting back, cutting back. Oh, great. Keep cutting back, fine. Needs to be done. But look what the consequences, and I'm not advocating more spending, not by a long shot. I'm just saying what the implications are going to be.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to start seeing higher unemployment. We're going into this downturn now, after this shock, this Wall Street, $8 trillion is blown away. And it doesn't come back. $8 trillion is lost. So now we're going into this next slowdown, this depression, at a much weaker position than we were the last time out.
Gerald Celente, the Trends Journal. Tell our listeners, Gerald, how they can get a hold of this journal. Again, I recommend it highly. It's a quality, handsome publication, loaded with great stuff you won't find anywhere else. Okay, I'm your biggest cheerleader. I'm not being paid to say this. It's just a great journal. How can folks get a hold of it?
Well, thank you. Trendsjournal.com, trendsjournal.com. And we have a discount request page there. And as you well know, the information is there to help people and so they can prepare for the future. So we know people are having a difficult time. We virtually try to make it available to everybody. Just fill out the discount request if you can't pay the full price, and we'll do our best to get it to you.
Excellent. Trendsjournal.com. Gerald Celente, always a pleasure, sir.
Hey, thank you.